X50. The king said, a ruler of the men, King Nemi, had given up his life as a result of his curse of his spiritual master, Vasista. The question is, how did he develop detachment from his body, which is source of all kinds of enjoyment? Why did he not agree to enter in his body when the demigods revive him? It has been heard that the great sage Vasistha also had to give up his life because of the curse of his disciple, but then receive another body. Devotee of the Lord certainly attain liberation. How after liberation does devotee again take birth? The illusory energy of Supreme Lord is incomprehensible. Even to the great elevated sages, this Maya, with her wide-gatheredness, bewilders the entire world, just like an expert magician. Text 80. Upon hearing those words of kings, Sachidwaja, who was very eloquent speaker, continued his talks with heart filled with devotion for Lord Krishna. Text 19. King Sushidwaja said, as a result of performing many pious activities and visiting many holy places for many lifetimes, a person receives the association of saintly persons by grace of Lord Krishna. By their sadhu sangha association, he gradually becomes qualified to approach the Supreme Lord. Such a person ultimately attained the abode of Lord Vishnu, where he engaged in the service of Lord without impediment. A devotee of the Lord enjoys a very blissful life, and he achieved fame in this world and saintly person. Text 21. Pure devotee worship Lord Hari with great enthusiasm, incessantly chant his holy names, and constantly try to keep the remembrance of his transcendental form within thy hearts. 22. They sometimes perform dramas of the pastime performed by the Lord's incarnations. They observe sacrifice, such as Ekadasi, and they organize great festivals wherein they worship Lord with great pomp. And devotees perform all those activities with great pleasure. Text 23. Devotees so much relish thy engagement in devotional service that they do not even care for liberation. Sometimes liberation liberate the soul, take birth in this world just to exhibit truth of Krishna consciousness, to preach Krishna consciousness. The devotees are not different from Lord Hari. Even holy places of pilgrimage become sanctified by thy presence. The devotee takes the essence of life, knowing very well that only devotional service to Lord can satisfy the soul. Text 25. As Lord Krishna sometimes appears in this world, so his devotee also comes to this world on his behalf. The Supreme Lord is always visible within the hearts of pure devotees. This is one of his pastimes. Text 26. It is for this reason that the great sage Vasistha, although liberated soul, accepted the material body of kings. I have thus briefly described the glories of devotional service and the Lord's devotees. By hearing those descriptions of one's sinful reactions shall quickly vanquish, so that one's devotional service to Lord Krishna is nourished. The controlling deities of the various limbs of his body also become pleased by such discussion. Such hearing counteracts all kinds of impediment, such as lusty desires and ignorance. Text 28. Exalt the devotees throughout the three worlds by following the footsteps of Srila Vyasadeva and Prabhupada. Attain the platform of unalloyed devotion service, which frees one from much abundance. Such devotion is attained by churning the ocean of Vedic literature, Puranas, and other Vedic literature, Srimad Bhagavatam. Unalloyed devotees are considered to be as good as Lord Krishna due to being his dear associate and servant. Thus ends the translation of the 26th chapter of Sri Kalki Purana. Next story. The story of Dvivida Gorilla, King Shashidvaja's previous birth as King Satrajit. Text 1. Sutta Goswami said, after happily narrating his story to all the members of the assembly, King Shashidvaja addressed Lord Kalki with folded hands. Text 2. King Shashidvaja said, my dear king, O master of the three worlds, all those kings are under your protection. We are ready to carry out whatever you order. Text 3. I now wish to go to Hardware Himalaya, which is very pleasing to the sages, and ask you penance. My sons and grandsons have taken shelter of you, and so please protect them. Text 4. O Lord of the demigods, I know that you are already aware of my intention. I'm sure that you remember how in your previous incarnation you had defeated Jambavan, the king of bears, and killed Dvivida Gorilla. That's me. 5-6. When the king finishes speaking and prepared to depart, along with his wife, Lord Kalki exhibited a mood of embarrassment and lowered his head. Upon seeing this, the king said, mighty Lord, where did King Shashidvaja say to you just now? Why have you lowered your head after hearing his words? Text 7. Lord Kalki said, mighty kings, you should ask this question to King Shashidvaja. He will certainly clarify everything because... Text 8. Being advised by Lord Kalki in this way, assembled king turned to Shashidvaja and spoke as follows. The king said, you are certainly very intelligent. What did you say to Lord Kalki? Why did he lower his head after hearing it? King Shashidvaja said, at that time, Lord Ramachandra manifests pastime, Lakshmana kill Indrajit. As a result, the son of Ravana was delivered from his life of Rakshasa. Text 11. As a result of killing the Brahmana with a fairy weapon, Lakshmana was affected by incapacitating fever. Upon seeing Lakshmana in this pitiful condition, Dvivida Gorilla, that's me, who was renowned physician, belongs to the dynasty of the Ashwina Kumaras, whispered a mantra into his ear. Text 13. He also wrote down the mantra, placed it over Lakshmana's head, and asked him to look at it. Text 14. When Lakshmana saw this mantra, his fever instantly subsided so that he became completely cured. Lakshmana then requested Dvivida Gorilla to ask for benediction. Text 15. In response, Dvivida Gorilla cheerfully said, I pray that I will die at your hands and thus be relieved of this lower form of body. Text 16. To this Lakshmana said, when in the future I appear as Balarama in Vrindavan, you will be killed by me and thus free from your life as a monkey. Text 17. Anyone who rides Dvivida Gorilla lives on the northern shore of the salt ocean on palm leaf and gazes at will, instantly cured of his fever. Text 18. If one simple writes this mantra and keeps it above his doorway so that he sees it every day, he will also become cured of all diseases. Text 19. Having received this benediction from Lakshmana, Dvivida Gorilla continued to live long and healthy life. Ultimately, he was killed by Lord Balarama and thus attained liberation. Text 20. Similarly, by his own will, Ramahasan Sutta gave up his life at the hands of Lord Balarama at Naimisharanya. O kings, when the incarnation of Lord Vamanadeva covered the three worlds with two steps, Jambavan, Singulambula, his right foot, Lord Vama became astonished to witness his great speed and said, O king of the birds, you are certainly very powerful. Now, ask me for benediction. Jambavan, who has expansion of Lord Brahma, replied with great pleasure, please award me benediction that I may be thy by means of your Sudarshan chakra. Lord Vamana said, when I descend to the earth in my original form as Lord Krishna, I will cut off your head with my chakra so that you will be liberated from material existence. Text 25. Therefore, at the time of Lord Krishna manifest pastime, I took birth a king, Satrajit, a great devotee of Sun God, because of rumors spread by me, Lord Krishna's reputation became tarnished. Text 26. I had a younger brother named Prasena. It so happened that Jambavan killed the lion that had taken my precious jewel. 27. The unlimited powerful Lord Krishna, out of fear of defamation, was searching for this jewel at this time. Finally, he came upon Jambavan within the mountain cave, and for the sake of the jewel, they fought. 28. The king of birds gradually came to recognize his worshipable Lord, so that duel ended peacefully. Thus, there was no need for Jambavan to be killed by Lord Krishna Chakra. The king of birds attained liberation, simple, by receiving darshan of Supreme Personality Godhead. Text 29. Jambavan gave not only the jewel, but also his daughter, Jambavati, to Lord Krishna, whose complexion was color of tender Durva grass. Text 30. Therefore, Lord Krishna returned to Dvoka and summoned me. He returned the jewel to me, even though his queens would have certainly cherished it. 31. I was embarrassed to discover that I had spread a false rumor about Lord Krishna. To save my face, I insisted that Lord keep the jewel, and I also gave him my daughter, Satyabhama, in marriage. The Lord gracefully accepted both from me. Text 32. After some time had passed, Lord Krishna returned jewel to me and went to Hastinapura, to Pandavas, along with Satyabhama, my daughter. Text 33. While the Lord was thus away from Dvoka, king named Satadhanva killed me and took the jewel. I certainly remember everything the Lord Kalki did in his previous incarnation. I have falsely accused Lord Krishna of stealing my jewel, and so I was not liberated from much existence at that time of my death. Therefore, in this lifetime, I will attain my goal by handing over my daughter Rama, the incarnation of Satyabhama, to Lord Kalki, the incarnation of Lord Krishna. Text 35. I hoped to be killed by Lord Krishna's Sudarshan Chakra. I was convinced that if I was killed by him in battle, that I would attain liberation. Now Kalki is here. After hearing how he had sanctioned the killing of his father-in-law, Kamsa, Lord Kalki, the master of the universe, exhibited embarrassment by lowering his head out of fear defamation. Text 27. All of a sudden, the king became very pleased, astonished he was hearing this wonderful story, while the sages became so absorbed in the contemplation Oh Lord, Kalki's, that's the qualities that they forgot thy separate existence. Those who hear this story as narrated by King Shashidwaja will be awarded happiness, fame, prosperity in this lifetime and ultimately attain liberation from birth and death and material existence. That's the end of the translation of the 27th chapter. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Beautiful story. I read this every day here in the past.